generally we don't use metals by themselves in dentistry. We generally use alloys because of the properties that we get from alloys instead of using a metal by itself. The only time when we use metal by itself, I think, is when we are placing implants. And the implant is made up of commercially pure titanium. Then we use the metal by itself. But otherwise, most of the time it is an alloy. But in substance, its metallic properties, it consists of two or more chemical elements. So there are two or more chemical elements, out of which one is a metal. So in simple terms, a mixture of two or more metals is called an alloy. Most metals have a white color except gold and copper. Okay. Gold is generally yellow, copper is generally reddish. And both of them form important components of cast blend alloys. Once upon a time, it used to only be gold alloys because of its corrosion resistance, but nowadays, because of the cost of gold, we have base metal alloys. But gold is still being used for people who are desirous of having gold restorations in their home. It's still being used. So most of the metals are white in color except gold and copper. Copper is generally reddish and gold is generally yellow. Now, pure metals and properties are kind of different. So, generally, there are some drawbacks when you use the pure metals. So, generally, we avoid with other metals so that we can get the properties of both, okay, which can be beneficial to us. Okay. So, when pure metals are properly alloyed, other metals and non-metals. Example, iron is alloyed with small amounts of carbon, producing steel. Okay, steel is an alloy of iron and carbon. And of course, when you add chromium, it becomes stainless steel. Okay? So, alloy of iron and carbon is steel. Because iron has got the property of rust, so you don't want rusting to take place, so you generally add chromium. Generally add chromium to make it stainless steel. When chromium is alloyed with carbon and iron, it is called stainless steel. Okay, which is resistant to corrosion due to the formation of chromium oxide. So it forms chromium oxide, it forms a layer and prevents the corrosion of steel. So certain carbon steel are electroplated with chromium to produce corrosion resistant instruments. Rusting is nothing but corrosion. We've already spoken that before. Okay? We've spoken about tarnish and corrosion. So, with the exception of pure gold foil, commercially pure titanium and hypnotic silver points. Now, I need not mention silver points to you because nowadays it's not being used. Silver points were once upon a time used as roofing materials. Okay, I have used it myself previously. So nowadays we don't use silver points. Okay? Other than that, you have gold foil. I don't know how many people use gold foil, but commercially pure titanium is what we use for implants. That can be used. The other dental restorations, partial denture frameworks, orthodontic wires, endodontic instruments are all alloys. Okay? So, when you alloy gold, what happens? The strength increases. Can it be compacted? It cannot be compacted. Gold foil needs to be compacted in the cavity. You put gold compacted. Now, the compaction can only take place if you have pure gold, which is soft. So, you press it against it. So each gold foil you press against and you fill up the cavity. Then you are going to alloy the gold. What's going to happen? It cannot be compacted. So it has to be used in the low form. Okay. Gallium and mercury are liquid at what temperatures? But when alloyed, they become a component of the solid alloy at all temperatures. Okay. So there are some metals that are liquid at room temperatures. Example is gallium and mercury. All pure metals and alloys used as restorative materials in dentistry are crystalline solids. Okay. So this should give you an idea. When you say crystalline solids, that is high strength. Okay. Crystalline solids have high strength. So far spoken about what is a metal, what is an alloy, what are the different types of metals that we use in dentistry. Okay. Most of the metals used in dentistry are in the form of alloys, except gold foil, silver coins, and commercially pure, also called as CP, titanium. Okay. Commercially pure titanium. All the other metals that are used are alloy. Most of the metals are white in color except copper and gold. Most of the metals are solid at room temperature except medium. Unique characteristics of metal alloys are described qualitatively and quantitatively with the properties and characteristics like brittleness, color, ductility, malleability, electrical and thermal conductivity, hardness. These are all properties of metals. Okay. You already spoken about, you know what is the meaning of ductile, you know what is the meaning of being malleable, electrical and thermal conductivity, hardness, luster, melting temperature, specific gravity, solderability, wear resistance and weldability. Okay. These are unique characteristics of metal alloys. Dental casting alloys are associated with the following groups. Dental amalgams, which contains mercury, silver, tin and copper. And even zinc also can be, you have zinc and non-zinc containing amalgams. So, main components are mercury, silver, tin and copper. Then you have high noble. High noble contains 40%